everyone. I'm Ryan. You're watching 60 Cycle Hum, and I've got a box here with a pedal made by a viewer. Look at this manual. It's the size of a placemat. What do we have here? I already know what it looks like. I don't know what it does or what it sounds like, but I do know it is just crazy looking. It's huge! Apparently there's only 5 of these in existence. And Josh Scott has one of them, and I've got one of them. I'm assuming the builder has one of them, and then there's 2 more out there in the world. I don't want to mess up his name, so let me look up our conversation here. The builder's name is Brandon Shock, and it's called the Joy Circuit Mood Manipulator. I'll put a link down in the description to his reverb shop, so you can contact him if you need more information. All right, let's plug it in and figure out what it does, because I honestly have no idea. He was just like, hey, here's a picture. You want to try this? And just looking at it, I was like, yeah, I want to try it. Oh, man. So what do we have here? We've got a gain control, a volume control, a mix control, another volume control, a lost knob, a three-way switch that goes from eons, chaos to stars. One of these joystick things. They have these on the Walrus Janus, which is a fuzz tremolo. I wonder what it does on here. Sorrow foot switch and a joy foot switch, and really fun, trippy, psychedelic art here. I love the look of this pedal. Oh, it's huge though. This is not a small pedal. All right, I'm going to turn on amps and we'll start messing around with it. I'm using my 2 Princeton's rig. Princeton's sit behind me, baby. That's what I said now. And I'm also going to use my Nutter Astro Captain because it's a fun guitar for a fun pedal. I'm assuming it's going to be a fun pedal. Humbucker setting on the bridge. I was just playing this a couple minutes ago, so I'm sure it's still in tune. It's in tune now. Keep an ear out. If it goes out of tune, let me know. Here's the neck pickup on the coil split setting. All right, let's check this thing out. Try to solve its mysteries. Turn on the sorrow side first, see what happens. You know what? The weather is shifting today. It's causing all kinds of tuning issues. That's a lot better. I'm assuming this is the volume control. Yeah, this isn't connected to this gain circuit. Either is the mix or the lost. Or anything else. So it's a 2-knob overdrive circuit on the sorrow side. A bit of a shelf there. Like, not a lot happens in between this whole range here, but you get to this shelf. And it turns into a more like spitty, fuzzy sort of sound. I think I'm gonna leave it with the gain all the way up for now. Let's explore this joy side. I have no idea what I'm about to get into. I will refer to the manual if I'm feeling lost. All right, here we go. That is freaky. I think I understand what's going on here. I haven't touched this switch yet, but there is a delay time control, which is your vertical back and forth here, and then there's like a modulation rate control, slow on the left, fast on the right, and I think this is like a mix between those two effects, between the modulation all the way on the right. That delay effect is a lot more subtle, up and down with this turned all the way to the right, but then I turn it all the way to the left. Yeah. When this is turned all the way to the left, it takes out that modulation, some sort of chorus, vibrato sort of thing. So this is your blend between two different effects that have two different axes of control across this joystick here. So left and right for the modulation, up and down for a time control on a delay. If you want both, then you put this at noon. Without the sorrow on. And then some very simple controls here, mix for all of this mess against your dry signal, and volume control as well. I don't know what this does yet. Some kind of tremolo on the star setting. I couldn't tell what was going on with the chaos setting. I'm gonna hit the manuals. So eons, chorus phaser at the heart of modulation. Choral voicing on one side of the blend, delay on the other. Yeah, I had that figured out. The chaos setting. The loss control in this setting is for the delay mix and the octave mix. The octave is to the right, the delay is to the left. There's an octave on the chaos setting. Time controls both the delay time and octave mix. For delay, it moves fast to the left and slowest on the right. The octave is highest at the right and lowest mix to the left. Space controls flanger speed, which is fastest at the top and slowest at the bottom. Flanger, octave, and delay. Finally, together at last. That octave. Just on the edge of being like John Carpenter in a box. Thank you. honestly have no idea what I'm doing right now. It sounds like some sort of medieval psychedelic trip. Super freaky. Who even comes up with this kind of stuff? All right, stars now, the last setting. This is the one with tremolo on it. The loss control in this setting is for the delay mix and tremolo mix. At the far left is the mod delay and or chorus. At the far right is full tremolo. Is it a mod? Is it a modulated delay or is it a chorus? Time controls both the delay time and tremolo speed. Tremolo speed is at the bottom, slow, and top fast. And the delay time is the shortest at the top and longest at the bottom. Space controls the chorus depth and delay mix. Far left is modulated delay. Far right, we have a deep chorus wave. That's pretty. Thank you. This whole thing is just a gigantic psychedelic freakout. If I had a time machine, I'd take it back in time and put it in the hands of, like, Rocky Erickson or something like that. What a trip. Who comes up with stuff like this? Brandon, this is ridiculous. You only made 5 of these? Well, guys, what do you think? Apparently, there's only 5. I don't think you can buy any of them. I've got one. Josh Scott has one. Brandon, I'm assuming, still has one. And then there's 2 out there in the wild somewhere. What a trip. What do you guys think of this? Would you use this? It's kind of like a create a sound that you couldn't otherwise create. Like blending in multiple modulations in this way. It's not the same as putting these modulations in a pedal chain together. They're blending and mixing in a very different style of way. And just, you know, scrolling around them with his joystick here is giving sounds that I'm frankly not sure what to do with. Like, if you want to have a pedal you throw on and now you are into full-on permanent freak-out mode, this is it. Totally bonkers. Totally bonkers. You think he should make more of these? Is there a demand? I've got his Reverb Shop link down below. If you want one of these, hit him up and tell him. And hopefully he'll make some more of them. All right. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, dislike, leave me rude and nasty comments. Support us on Patreon. Buy a shirt if you're naked. And stay grounded. Yeah, stay grounded. Bye, everybody.